Adam, it's always something. So now the Jets in Buffalo will not play in Buffalo. What are the alternatives now? Where do you think it's going to end up? What day and where?
Well, right now, I think the Bills and the NFL and the Jets are trying to figure that out. And I know that there have been some reports and some speculation that Detroit seems to have emerged as a favorite. I think Washington still very well may be in the picture here. Detroit sounds like it could ultimately be the destination. We do know it will not be Buffalo. It will not be Sunday. And so it looks like they're moving that out. And again, I think it'll be Monday night. I think it'll be about 7 o'clock. I think the favorite is Detroit. I think Washington's in the picture. I know the Bills have been notified to be ready to leave town tomorrow because they have not practiced in 2 days. And, you know, let's be honest here. I was out in Denver, living in Denver in 1997, where there was about 30 inches of snow, and Denver was trying to get out to get to Buffalo, ironically enough, for a football game there. And it was like a disaster area. I mean, there were a lot of threats to public safety, and it's the same thing in Buffalo. I mean, there are people right now who can't get food, whose roofs are collapsing. You are not allowed to drive anywhere on the road. If there's someone that needs medical care, it's obviously very difficult to navigate everything that's going on there right now. You've got, 4 feet of snow already, 2 more feet of snow coming. The snow budget to clean everything up has already been allotted for the year, and it's November 20th. I mean, it's just really a crazy situation that people are having to live through in a certain part of town in Buffalo. And right now, everybody's trying to navigate it. The football is the least of things, but obviously it's what we're talking about because everybody's curious to see where the Bills and the Jets will wind up playing on this weekend.
You surprised, Adam, that it's taken so long? I mean, we had 5 feet of snow a couple days ago, and here we are Thursday night approaching the weekend of the game, and we still don't know what's going on.
Well, I think they're waiting to see, and the way somebody explained it to me is that the Bills will be hard-pressed to play their next home game in Buffalo, which is a week from Sunday against Cleveland. I think the stadium already has 5 feet of snow. It takes on average 3 days to remove 1 foot of snow. They're expecting rain over the weekend, which could freeze everything and turn the whole stadium into a layer of ice. There obviously are going to be some flooding issues when that snow melts off and the rains come. I mean, it's a bad situation for that area right now that everybody's trying to get through. And I think a lot of times the NFL is holding out hope that the game will be able to go on in the city that it's supposed to be played at. But in this particular case, that's not going to happen.
Well, let me ask you this, because obviously it's such a big, big television product. The word came out today, 18 of the 20 highest-rated television shows this year are football games. So if the game's played a Monday at 7, Monday Night Football's at 8:30, Adam, where will the game be televised?
I don't remember how they did that the last time. It's a good question. I'd have to go back and look at it. It'd probably be on CBS, I would guess. And then they've got to work with the networks. And that's part of this, too, is making sure that you can get the broadcast trucks that were supposed to be in Buffalo, that may have been on their way to Buffalo, over to the location that they do choose, be it Detroit or Washington or wherever it may be. I mean, there are all sorts of logistical things. I had somebody tell me today that the equipment people in Buffalo, they can't get the uniforms because they were getting cleaned.
Wow.
And how do they go get them before they leave town when no one there in Buffalo is working? And I mean, it's just all sorts of stuff that you would never think of. And then you think back again to when I was in Denver, and there were some players, and this will come up again, there were some players who didn't want to leave their family in a crisis-type situation. You don't want to leave, you know, young kids or a wife at home, and yet you're being asked to leave that area, evacuate a disaster zone, really, to go practice and play a football game when some people are going to be apprehensive about leaving their family behind.
Are you under the impression that under no circumstance will this game be played on Sunday? This is going to be a Monday or Tuesday event?
I think right now all indications point to Monday. But again, I'm not privy to these specific conversations, but everything that I've heard is Monday seems to be the indication.
Now, there is some precedent, especially with the New Orleans situation, that you could play a game in the other team's stadium. Is there any thought at all to MetLife?
I'm sure that has been discussed. I have not heard that is a viable option just yet. But, again, they're looking for all sorts of scenarios. They need to focus first on getting the Bills out of Buffalo. Two straight days they haven't practiced, okay? Just trying to get ready for a game. The Jets are going through practices. And, again, I don't think the people in Western New York are worried about the Jets having a competitive advantage, but that's really what it comes down to at this particular moment, is the Jets have had a competitive advantage this week. The Buffalo Bills are, they're locked up in their houses. They can't go out. They can't do anything. And so That has to be an advantage for the Jets, and that's why the Bills are trying to get out of town, if that's even possible right now, to get to the city that they choose, whatever city that is, so they can go to a practice at some point tomorrow night once they get set up wherever they're going.
You do feel confident they will play this game during Week 12?
Yes, that will get done.
Now, we had a little bit of a discussion back and forth, and Dave said, I want to ask Adam Schefter this question. So, you know, we know that you're a reporter, but you love football, and you watch it all the time. So ask him the question, Dave.
All right. Winning one game it was, yes? Yep. Tom Brady or Aaron Rodgers right now?
Right now?
Uh-huh.
Today?
Yeah.
Just for one game?
That's right.
Equal talent.
So we're not taking a quarterback for the next 5 or 10 years?
No.
Today.
Today.
I think I still I hate to say this because I'm a huge Tom Brady fan, and he's the most genuine guy I've ever met in the sport of football, but I think I'd go Aaron Rodgers.
There you go.
Yeah, that's what we said. But Dave said it wasn't even close. I thought it was close.
I think Rodgers is playing at this crazy level that is way higher than Brady right now.
I wouldn't say he's way higher than Tom Brady. Tom Brady is, I mean, his touchdown to interception ratio over the last 5, 6, 7 games is outrageous, and he's an MVP candidate. So, I mean, Aaron Rodgers is in a different world. This is like Mark McGuire and Sammy Sosa without any performance-enhancing drugs involved.
It's amazing. Any new news on Adrian Peterson's situation?
No, the appeal is going to be heard, the first Tuesday in December. Again, I think the NFLPA is fighting to make sure that Roger Goodell doesn't hear it. I don't think that's possible, but we'll see how that shakes out. I think the bottom line to that situation, and we spoke about this a little bit on Monday or Tuesday, whatever we last spoke, I lose track of the days. You know, I think that Adrian Peterson's hopes of coming back this season have been dashed, and that's not going to happen. He will not play this season.
Anything on Ray Rice? And when's that decision coming down?
For the judge's decision, the arbitrator's decision, Judge Jones, to see what she decides. But you know, keep in mind, anybody that wants to sign Ray Rice can sign him today, technically. They're allowed to do that. But I think anybody that have any interest would want to see if he's reinstated, and even then we'll see how warmly he's received around the league at that point.
If you were a betting man and you had money to burn on this, would you bet that Tom Coughlin was back or not back for the Giants next year?
Well, I'm not a betting man. I don't like to bet money. But my feeling on this has been that Tom Coughlin has such stature and such respect within that organization, with the owners of that organization, that when he goes, whenever that is, he is going to engineer his own departure, and it'll be a graceful exit, and it will be done the way he wants it to be done. I am of the mind that he will get to stay on, no matter how the rest of the season goes, because he's earned that with the type of job that he's done through the years, with the type of man that he's been through the years, and with the type of coach he is. Now, again, maybe the Maras or Tishes blow that up, but I just think that he commands such respect that he gets to stay on as a 10-year coach of the Giants until the team and he figure out a way that he can get out gracefully and by both their decisions.
Adam, great stuff. Thank you so much for filling us in on this.
Thank you, guys. Have a great day.